Hai, shalom, shalom,
shalom.
First and foremost, when
you were praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Kakurash.
We know that we're going to study the 11 apostles of great millstone.
Shalom.
Salutation to the Akiyam, which we're going to shoot to the four corners of the earth. You understand? My name is Brother Yakal from the GMS Prophetic Vibration Camp.
Brother Yassad.
Brother Yahardam.
Brother Howard.
Alright, and this video we're going into is, you know, cast away idols, because right now we're seeing that the all the heathens them casting away the idols. We know a lot of brothers are gonna do videos on the same topic. You understand? Mm-hmm. The Spirit come on me to do a video on this topic. Right? Because it was actually written in the Bible and thus says the Lord, it happening right now. You understand? We live in the time to see it happen.
Because we also know through the words and the power Yahweh Hashem Yahushai do avoid. You know, it must come to pass.
Can I just start saying it too, that, like what previous video say?
Going to
that we know we in the end, because how we know we in the end, because we see in prophecy coming to pass, going back into the book of 2nd Ezra chapter 9, talking about when you see signs of the part of the signs, part of the end of the highest, right? There is the deal which he created. So all these things is knowing that the Abashim Rashai, right? There is the deal which he created. So hey, all praises to Abashim Rashai. And hey, this is a joyful thing to know that hey, we live in the last days. So I mean, you I'm gonna choose some scriptures to this for that for Yahashim Rashai, who will be edifying, you know, to the look at Israel. Read out now. Yes, I'll read out now.
The book of Isaiah chapter 2:18, and the idols he shall utterly abolish.
Right.
Yeah. And they shall go into the holes of the rocks and into the caves of the earth for the fear of the Lord.
Right, so that's going into they being frightened for the things that the Lord gonna make happen on the face of the earth. You understand? Because what you seeing people dropping like flies right now, that's just the beginning. You understand? But the Lord say it's gonna be terrible like you never see before. You understand? The place gonna get worse and worse like you never see before. So that idol, that them idols being abolished is just one thing, you understand? This simple little plague is just one thing, you understand? The Lord began to plague it as it.
When he arises to shake terribly the earth.
Right, because the Lord shaking the earth right now as we just all go out in the sea. We always see in chariots pouring out the vials, we always see you know, the Lord stirring up the place. The Lord beginning to shake up the place, right? But read that.
Yeah. In that day, a man shall cast his idols of silver and his idols of gold,
can.
Which they made each one of himself can. To worship.
So that's the, you know, just to prove that to you, I'm going to get the video. If anybody can get the video, considering we're going in India and things, so you can get it in chat. We can tell you what your phone there for, say, the video considering. So you see a thing in here going on right now, they train up with a million gods. Yeah, because we know this thing, most of them are a million gods. I when they read that article where I post up, they actually printed the corona, the spread of disease. Yes, and all these things, hey, Yahweh Hashem Rashai put there for the even Israelize it too, because a lot of these so-called Indians and them going back to the Punjabis are Israelites in India. So hey, all praise to Yahweh Hashem Rashai that we seen that hey. Prophecies coming to pass, all these Hindus and all these Elamites going back to the biblical name is treating away the idol gods. So you can get the video, you get the video, yeah? Yeah. Take on the video, they put it which way, you know? Treat how you treat me, right?
No,
I said to me that we're going to treat me the same way too. Right. So you actually see that they're you know,
they're burning
and they're throwing away the idols. You see a van load of idols there. You know, and what's going on? It's so funny. You know?
Should I put it big?
Yeah, don't put it big. Sideways.
Sideways?
Oh, it's that. So lucky, yeah, you know, you just get the arm. He said things are real. Right. More we lay back. More we lay back here.
Alright. Alright, let's see what's going on in India right now. So all them million gods, they're casting it away, you know. And as the brother say, all that cement and all them, you know, they self and what, but they take the time to build a house and live in it. And you understand? And build all these murties and these idol gods and have it dumping in the sea. You understand? Or say they're polluting the sea right now. They're all the rivers and in the tree, now all the areas. So the scripture, they actually show you the Bible, you know. Is it truth? But nothing but the truth. You understand? Because you know the reason why they're doing that is because I'm going to see the video here. 3 minutes video. Right on. Yeah. I got this one here, what you waiting on here? This is the reason why. Them hidden, them just dropping down and watch. You understand? So this is the reason why they casting away their gods, which are no gods. You understand? Because they not they calling upon their gods, going back into the scripture with Elijah. They burning this, they cutting themselves, they butting their head on the rock. All kind of thing they're trying to do to for the God to get them that answer. But the God on silent because it's deaf and dumb. It's deaf and dumb, it can't even talk. You know? Yeah. So you actually see touch. See all praises to Yahweh Shem and Shine, it even at Israelites. Among these heathens, who looking just as the heathens, but Israelite going back to the speckled birds, Israelite foreigners, you know? So, hey, what about that? So, you actually seeing what's going on? They're casting away their idols, you know, because why? But it's just dropping, you know, the second wave is cleaning them up, and they're seeking the idol God, but they ain't getting no answer, they ain't getting, it ain't talking to them, you know? So hey, and it's so funny because all the Elamite in Trinidad here printed their false idol and going back into their motherland, the Hindus are them throwing away the fucking idols. So best to take all the idols in Trinidad and fucking throw it in the sea too. You understand? Because it ain't gonna save them any time a rod come and Yahweh Hashem shall come down with wrath and bring forth plagues on the earth. There's nothing to save them. You understand? So go down in the scripture. I'm more in the scripture that you bring.
Psalms 110:6. He shall judge among the heathen. He shall fill places with the dead bodies.
So actually, we actually seeing on the roots, on the road, all on the pavement, the dead bodies. I think we don't go into the video. You see a whole road full of dead bodies, little children. So you don't have no pity. You don't have respect to that person. No pity for all these hospital. You know, some nations got all them come to the hospital. So they're on the ground like spit. You know. So we really care, and we even being sorry for these heathens. And even to tell our people who they too, hey, is a righteous judgment from Yahweh Hashem, you know, Shai. So they gain their portion. Elam is gaining their portion. And just now, actually, they're, hey, and all these other nations going to get their portion. Esau, Edom, Ishmael, Ham, all these other heathen nations going to get their judgment from Yahweh Hashem, you know, Shai, even to tell our people.
He shall wound the heads over many countries.
Yeah.
15 and 14.
Yeah, he said, was the master on 14-11, he said, therefore, even upon the isles of the Gentiles, therefore, even upon the isles of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation, because in the future of Yahweh they are become an abomination, a stumbling block to the souls of men and a snare to the feet of the anointed.
Right, so I'm going to read it over. It said, therefore, even upon the idols of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation. Right, so the Lord not just visiting the people on earth and visiting all the creation and just the because everything gonna get a visitation, the land gonna get plagued with pestilence and diseases. The people are going to get played with farming and all kind of different things, right? And the idols getting a visitation too. Imagine even the idols, the dumb idols that you know, the Lord going to visit them as well too. The Lord visiting them and the Lord casting away them, right? Because you say, of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation, because in the creature of Yahweh, they have become an abomination, right? Because in the man, they have become an abomination. Even the makers who make it, the Lord going to deal with them too, because they make these idols for our people, and because our people love to follow the ways of the heathen. You understand? So that's why our people fall under that trap too. Because a lot of them in India, they never know they can be jakes. You understand? A lot of them can be jakes. They don't dwell and mingle with their nation.
And that's the odd, because when you really watch it go back into it, most of Moses go on to meet Yahweh Shemesh in Mount Sinai, we'll go on to make a golden calf. And that is there, and warm here, and then we take all the coal here and all the coal and make that gold cast. So that should show you, you understand, that is our customs that he done. They follow the customs, and when the Lord do, the Lord swallow them up.
Come.
You understand, Aaron, tell his son to sell a slaughter of them out. You understand, so they put them to aid. So what's the punishment for serving other God? Which is one of the first commandments, thou shalt serve no other God, but Yahweh Shemesh. That's one of the jealous commandments, so hey, you get protected quickly for that. So when they see all these bodies dropping and all things in India, it could be Israelites, because hey, Yahweh Shemesh has scattered us to the four corners of the earth. So I'll bring all the scripture in Deuteronomy chapter, you jump back into here. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 26, I want to go to 27. It says, I call heaven and earth to witness against you this day that ye shall soon utterly perish from off the land whereunto ye go over Jordan to possess it. What's that, man?
You read
that? Read it back to you. It's I call heaven and earth against you this day that ye shall soon utterly perish from off the land whereunto ye go over Jordan to possess it. Ye shall not prolong your days upon it, but shall utterly be destroyed. So you actually see it, so you plenty of these heathens, them who, well, Israelites who looking like heathens, Israelite foreigners, going back to the speckled roots, who you see them falling down and all these things, even they're talking their language as the Elamites in India, but hey, they could go back to Israel. They could go back to Israel the same way. Because here we say here in verse 27, say, Yahweh Shemesh shall scatter you among the nations, and ye shall be left few in numbers, in number among the heathen, whether ye shall lead, whether Yahweh Shemesh shall lead you. Verse 28, it say, and there ye shall serve gods, the work of men's hands, wood and stone, which neither see, nor hear, nor eat, nor smell.
So that just to show you that these gods is nothing, right? But the Lord still gonna make you perish and make your gods perish before your eyes. So there's nothing, and there was never nothing, you understand? So even all the sacrifices they did and all the things that they did was nothing, because your gods was nothing.
They were just in vain.
Exactly. So that's why they cast them away. But let me go back into this piece up here. The wisdom of Solomon 14 and 11 is going down. Let's see. And an abomination and stumbling blocks to the souls of men, and a snare to the feet of the unwise. So all these idols were just an abomination to be on the earth in the first place, because Because everybody is supposed to give all praise to you, how about Shimmy or Shai? But I'm not. That's why even it was Belteshazzar.
Mm-hmm.
Even Belteshazzar say that Daniel's Lord was the Lord. That's paraphrasing, right? They say that he was the one true Lord because even the heathens didn't know. Even them didn't know, but now that the heathens do know and it have a time coming that the heathens going and weak back up and know that hey, it have one God because they're gonna get forced. They're all gonna shake the place so terrible that even the heathens gonna know.
That's right? What
Jeremiah 6 and verse 21, it says, therefore, thus saith Yahweh, behold, I will lay stumbling blocks before this people,
mm-hmm.
and the fathers of the sons, and the fathers and the sons together shall fall upon them.
Can. So, he's stating that the Lord put all these stumbling blocks concerning you growing up in a hidden, around the heathens and them and following the customs, because he putting all these molten images for you. But to see if you go really serve these immortal images, okay. And the Lord will actually make you serve it, yeah. And then take you from serving it, and show who's the real one and only living power, coming down to the end, showing you who's the one and only living power. Like the brother was saying concerning about this Shaza with Daniel, yes, and what yes, everybody, all the nations going back into the scripture that the knowledge of Yahweh Hashemesh can spread to the four corners of the earth. So we got all the Israelites going to wake up. Yes, and he doesn't gonna wake up to know who we are, and that way Esau getting mad for right now, and know that he have a shot, and that way he ruling out with his wickedness, the so-called pandemic, and bringing forth this so-called cure. Yes, and because they wanna bring down the number of the population in the world. Yes, and because you know what, he have a short time. This wicked fucker being real. Yes, and Esau eat them. Yes, and so hey.
This man watch me, this hand man, and how they gonna build it? They gonna build it with foot thing, right? As they say up in the verse before it, right? They gonna build it up, how they build up thing, they stand up, they gonna fasten it on a wall now.
You know what comes to my head? Because Yasser is a son, right? Well, when they mix the cement to plaster the wall, where's going on to mix that certain way?
Yeah,
so when they slap that cement on that wall, they so the mess is falling back out. They,
yeah,
and they fix it back up. So this picture, this is just how these heathens gods are. You understand? Like a fucking like when they mix cement, the plaster wall is the cement on the wall. Come as they go, but I want silver wall.
Yeah,
do like the Amalekites. And go and put your head and serve the wall. Yes, and serve cement.
We are creating the cement factory.
But then you best thing you do is to get around the cement factory and worship the cement factory. Because that will be lending like water to them.
No, well, you see how they see corona is a disease and that.
Worship corona.
The god and disease.
No, yeah. Then 300 million gods. But hey, what praise they have about shipping or shy? That hey, we come from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the chosen seed. Pray to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. You understand?
Yeah,
and eight.
Yeah, continuing. It says,
sweet, yes.
It says, for as it is an image, it had need of help.
So, hey, so going back into the world, our brothers to bring on the scripture for me. In Baruch 6, you guys going down into one or two details were on point. Because, hey, these heathens, they have it in their back. Toting it, putting in the back of a van, so why can't walk with them? Why can't dance with them?
Yeah.
You understand? Why can't celebrate with them?
But that's the pause one place and the total. Yeah, so another 2 day goes.
Can that was saying with 17 and say, then make it he pray for his for his goods, for his wife and children, and it is not a shame to speak, to speak to that which hath no life.
So it doesn't show you how the, so hey, that why Lord say envy not the heathens and choose none of their ways. Yeah. So by you studying things of this world and focusing on vanity, on house, on land, all these things, customs of heathen, because you worshipping these things with profiting you, with another deliverer, which is vain things.
Hey, you
understand?
Well, that, to add to just as the brother in there said, they have no shame to speak to it, and that's to show the faith towards them idols they have. You know, you are not under it.
It's not too much, but it's like, you see, for health, he call it upon that which is weak.
So, hey, you're probably talking about
with wisdom of Solomon 13 and 18, it's for health, he call it upon that which is weak.
So, what's going on right now in there? The jumping like flies to the ball in. So, that's why they're showing away their false gods. That's why they're showing away the gods which are no gods.
The sick,
so, they need help. So they call out to the seamen God, you understand? They not answer.
They know that they have a God for everything. They have a God for wealth, they have a God for health.
Yeah.
They have a God for prosperity, you know what I mean?
So they call up on the God for strength. And they get a fucking strength, they call up on the God for cure. They get the cure jumping on you like flies.
And then
obviously you have a shoe no shy boy. Yes, and even to the people who get put to death all the way, you always say you have a shoe no shy. You understand?
And what about it? Them will be still training away God some since the start. Because we are going to have the same thousands of God idols training away in the street.
Thousands of, I know I'm saying, you can't build a fucking house.
And
there
are millions of
goods. You understand? So, hey, what priest say about Shimon Shai, boy? These kind of things, knowing, hey, and this is a booster in this world, boy. These things boosting this world, they know, hey, will it bring any last year? And even fear. Fear, and that's the whole thing about it, having fear they have about Shimon Shai. And that saying, hey, to what I have about Shimon Shai, that we come from our darkness, pray to the idol Jesus. That's how the white man paint his picture with. Going back into the Apocrypha reveal who's the image of paint and give us and all these things. He has to go to the Catholic and all these things. We got out of that darkness. We come into our true heritage, Jeremiah 17:4, and worshiping Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. You understand? So hey, is that hey? Hey, you really have faith, go take the green hand, to fall in your hands and Yahweh Hashem
Yahushai. Yeah, because hey, imagine you living this life. And all of these things happening, and you don't know what to do, where to run to.
No answers.
Yeah.
No question. You have all the questions, and you have no answers.
But you see, the thing about it, they're so wicked and they're so into their ways. They had the answer, but they reject it.
Yeah. That's why you don't say he shows his hand to rebellious nation, because, hey, when you're something here, he's not buying you. That's why you go to say that, hey, they're going to be looking for us, boy. They're going to be looking for us, but you're going to be too late. That's why, hey, that's why it's farm, that he would. All these things because, hey, as these other nations' kingdoms fall in, and we bringing them down spiritually and bringing out the truth on the YouTube, they getting mad. You understand? They play with our views. They play with our showing us more old people subscribing to us that watching us. You understand? All these things striking our channels. You understand? It's not this the truth. Is that this the truth? Why? You understand? If it wasn't the truth, they would not be deleting me and striking me and oh gosh, man, common sense. You understand? That's why he operates there, I'm asking you, sure. Some brethren even use certain language and certain races, nothing, but you're striking for YouTube, breaking YouTube policy. All these things is part of Esau, Edom, wicked plan. You understand? To hide this truth, to hide this wood. You understand? Why anything I'll ever bring up now?
Yeah, slack guy, see, for health, he call it upon that which is weak.
You see, so which are weak, boy? Because if it needs something to hold up itself, how you can pray to this thing for help, but it can't even help itself?
That need help from you. That need help you.
Yapa. It need help from you, but you help from it.
Better you be he God instead.
Better you be he God instead.
They'll show how foolish these heathens is. And you know, follow the heathens. And hey, the way you like my property, boy. The way you Lord say, hey, you understand? The poor will inherit the kingdom of heaven, boy. Okay. You understand? So I go through my own chastisement. You understand? You don't preach to you about Shem and Shai. When I'm walking, and I'm driving, and I'm flying a plane. You understand? I'm within the nuts and for hours for a car. You understand? The travel. You don't preach to you about Shem and Shai, boy. You understand? Guy going through, I had to go through because why? You understand? These are all I'm coming back. It was with King Niggas. We transgress against Yahweh, Shem and Shai. But now we wake us up again to realize, hey, I fought him. You understand? So what they be for me, so that might be your King Hives and Bives, and we sit down here doing our video to edify the flock to show them, hey, repent. And if you repent, you will die, boy.
If you don't repent, you will die.
Yeah, if you don't repent, you will die, boy. You understand? And going back into the idol, going back into idolism, you understand? They can hang like the brothers, they can slaughter their pastors, boy. Mm-hmm. You understand? They can slaughter their pastors because why? Pastor don't even pocket on full, and you know, sow a seed this morning, pay your tithes, they don't like that. You understand? Bring she up on the altar, they don't like that. And them time when pastor running, he told boots on and you be churning for your life. You understand? When they pass the true village, the same pastor saying they're putting on trees. You understand? When they're putting the whole full suit too.
Yeah. But the shirt and the tie. And the head falls, prophet.
But you watching just recently, Selakia. You watching just recently, tell a woman pastor. They don't show how this world, and it look like in the Nigerian, in Nigeria. She pull out, she breast and she in holy milk, and then she started pushing and started like he demons on here. She went, you can tell me this is where we live in it? Huh? I don't want to envy the heathens and choose their ways. Huh? Are they going to get put to death by your bashi, my shy boy? Can they bring out thing now?
It's a for life prayer to that which is dead.
Living praying to the dead, you understand? Be living praying to something that's not even in existence. You created that, you understand? You created that, nobody could create soul but you have
about Shem or Shai.
Right, so read that.
It says, for aid, humbly beseecheth that which had least means to help.
How was that aid? Like, really help? Come up to help, see him with you.
Like, he is help, like, oh yes, I don't know, see.
Yeah. So, we're gonna help something, we can't even help itself. You understand? You usually help, and the whole thing, they have to put the iron, they have to put the proper tub, they put in the sun to dry. All the.
And hey, all of this, all of them thinking they're doing and prospering, it is just that the Lord put in the way that they.
That's
the
right.
Fall upon
that's
us.
Right.
And the blessings
fall on them, boy. Because, hey, that's why the Lord said, hey, considering the scripture we bring out the other day, I think it is Sirach 10 and 18, or 10 and 6, and we're talking about the kingdom is translated from one to another, boy.
Yeah,
so we're going through right now because we can't inherit that kingdom without going through the fire. So all these things have place for the heathens and to be on the curses, like, you know, we're going to be low on the heathens and the children are going to be high above us. So they all have these curses because we transgress against the law, we fall off, and the Lord have been going through our curses, have been going through chastisement. You understand? Well,
see, and for a good journey, he asketh of that which cannot set a foot.
So them taking the idol gods and putting it on a van and charge. They make it on a boat or they might lift them and put it on a boot. They can't even dive in the water, they're not choosing the water. You understand? We don't know. So let us show you, it's sweet, boy. It's sweet. Let us show you what we're doing in there right now, it's sweet. Let us show you that the prophecy is coming to pass, whether.
Yeah, the book of Isaiah chapter 42 and verse 17. They shall be turned back. They shall be greatly ashamed that trust in graven images, that say to molten images, ye are our gods. Just as look at what happened to the heathens and them. Right now they're turning from their mind from worshipping Mother Lakshmi and the thousands of gods. They're being ashamed. Because all the time, they could have come now, they could have come now to an Israelite man and show off and be like, we gain prosperity and wealth. But what? They are ashamed now. If you go up to Elamite now, and you say, well, hey, how come you're training away with the birds?
Because you're training away with God yet? Look, home by your mother land in there, where all of them there, or the lineages, they were training away with the God. What could they with you? Mm-hmm. The vets have no answer. What are they going to do with the stomach? Mm-hmm. You know, because it's the truth. You know
that? Well, that is it.
You know that? Alright, yeah. Bring out in a farm group, chapter 6, and it can set from 17. Right, page 106.
This is Luke chapter 6. And verse 17.
Just
For like as a vessel that a man useth is nothing worth when it is broken. Even so it is with their gods.
So come like this picture of vase, like a clay pot. You understand? Like a clay pot, for instance, you know? Take this clay pot, and then chill this clay pot on the ground. We're going to go on it. Can I use this clay pot again? So this is all this clay pot that I fall in the mashup. Just so as the gods. Yeah, sir.
Molten images.
Can. What
happened? Yeah, continuing. It's when they be set up in the temple, yeah, their eyes be full of dust.
To the feet. When they be set up in the temple,
their eyes be full of dust to the feet of them that come in.
Yeah, because remember, these idols can't clean themselves. When you just have an item pack up there, and you know why you pin it down and it can't clean itself, it's just going and get dust.
Can.
Yeah, you go ahead.
Yeah, verse 18. It says, and as the doors are made sure in every side, upon him that offended the king as being committed to suffer death.
Right.
Even so the priests make fast their temples with doors, with locks, and bars, lest their gods be spoiled with rubbers.
Because they had to lock up the idol gods. If there is a thief, the idol can't fight them out themselves. So they lock them up.
Can cage them up.
That reminds me when I was a Muslim, me and my next brother used to go in the temple, right? And we have pizza hand, and we see Mother Lakshmi, so I'm beating up Mother Lakshmi hand. You understand? And we said that we didn't see fairly, they had to lock it up because Mother Lakshmi can't save herself. I was a wicked JK them time, man. We just seen them idols and them and decimating it. Right?
But
them can't save themselves.
Can.
Like that's the show here. The see not, the hear not, the feel not.
Can.
You can read from Reba from 11 and go down all the way.
Yeah, Reba from 11.
Yeah, can. If you look at Ruth, it's 6 and it's 11.
I read the letter of Jeremiah now. But still, you know, in the Apocrypha, it's written in Mokaburu.
Yeah, them books together.
But the brothers and sisters know this, you know? So, we don't know.
It's Luke 6 and verse 11. It says, yeah, they will give. They off to the common harlots and deck themselves as men with garments, being gods of silver and gods of gold and wood.
Right, so they're just basically saying that they have to deck them, they have to put clothes on them, you understand? They, like common harlots, right? That way they have to do this for them.
Yeah, verse 12 it says, Yet cannot these gods save themselves from rust and moths.
Right, so it says basically these gods can't replenish themselves, you understand? They can't make themselves right. Fresh gold today and they start to rust and then they make back themselves fresh gold the next day. It don't work so, you understand? They had to change their gods. Or they are there, you know, painted or some kind of thing. The gods do replenish themselves. They can't do this thing. They can't save themselves from rusting. They can't save themselves from dying. But yet they the god, yet you worshiping the god. But they can't save themselves from dying. Right? Worried.
It said, though they be covered with purple raiment, yeah, they wipe their faces because of the dust of the temple.
Right, so these idols just sit down in a temple and they had to come and dust your face and wipe your face, but you're a big god. You understand? You're some big something to worship. You can't be something to worship.
Can that god get freeze or
cobweb?
And I just to show you how foolish the people really is. How foolish you to really worship these gods. You make the doing of the Lord work confuse you, right? But the Lord wanted it to be like this, you understand? Because the Lord wouldn't want these heathens who do all these abominable things to worship the one true. But at that time they will worship the one true God.
Okay.
And that's when they living righteous. First of all, the heathens are not going to be living righteous because they're gonna be under the righteous power of Yahweh Shai and the 144,000 men. Under the righteous kingdom. So so basically we're saying with which
Still clean and stuff to what it say. They wipe their faces because of the dust of the temple where there is much upon them.
Right, so they heavily covered in dust because somebody had to come and wipe their face and somebody had to take care of them. And you understand? And I was saying that the heathens get confused because the Lord, as the Akim was saying, the Lord raised up the heathens above us. Right, so by they being above us and having everything and having money and having this and living nice, they think that, you know, they think that is their God making that for them. They think that they worshiping their God and that's why they getting all this. You understand? But the Lord doing, the one true power, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, did this. You understand? And make them feel as though it's them, it's their gods. Right? But when you think about it, they're foolish because your gods can't do nothing.
Can't. Life was 14.
And, yeah, let me say, I don't tell anybody, I just know they are these wicked jakes and them. They want to follow the heathen and the man do exactly what they're doing. It's an abomination in the face of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Verse 14 it says, and he that cannot put to death one that offended him, holdeth a scepter as though he were a judge of the country.
Right, he cannot put to death, he cannot bring a life, he cannot do nothing, as we were just saying. Your God cannot do nothing, but you have a big scepter in your hand. He has about six different hands, you understand? And he just did. You understand? He can't even wipe his sweat. Right? If somebody was to come and piss on him, he can't even be in that.
Tell them to cut up their head, sir.
Exactly.
They come with the milk and the honey and the children and the children and the fucking.
Yeah, the next day when the milk and the honey, suddenly the milk and honey evaporate, they say go drink it.
Pastor ants come and drink the
Or something that was hungry dog passing and see that milk and drink no
milk. Yeah, but 15 say, he that also in his right hand a dagger and an axe, but cannot deliver himself from war or thieves.
And when I watch the Lord garnish or sheep or whatever, yeah, well, go big sword in your hand, yeah, next with a bow, all that weapons of destruction. But you can't kill a man who pee on you. You can't even kill a man who take away your chain. You understand? It's so funny, boy. It's so funny. You understand?
Man.
But what going on with Israel Sham? What do you want the temple as it is?
But yeah, the temple in the sea.
Yeah.
Them take all the gold and all them things from them flicking them other gods and then why did them? And I thought about 6, 7, 8, 9 of my gods. Why did they take a why one of them didn't come and say, hey, freeze? So you don't fucking freeze already, you fuck.
Yeah, that like good. 15 say from war and thieves. You can't save yourself from war and thieves.
You can't save yourself.
If somebody was to go on, if I was to take up myself and go and war them idols in that anything and sneak in, I war all them idols myself because I just had to take a, you know, a hard sledgehammer and pong every one of them head in easy. And they can't do nothing. Right? So verse 16. It say, whereby they are known not to be gods, therefore fear them not.
Can.
Right? So that is why we were saying, when I was younger, and I was looking at these gods, they used to put some kind, you know, because I was watching the face of a demon-like and again, frightened.
With but blood when they, on the tongue.
Right? When I was a kid, but coming into the truth and coming to the understanding that all these witchcraft that they work and all the power that they calling upon all these demons, they cannot do you nothing. You under the protection of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai.
I can shit on these gods.
Exactly, we can shit on these gods because every day.
Look at all the scriptures, birds and them shitting on the gods. Bird, doves, all them shitting on the gods. You understand? That is kind of like is a toilet god already. Because all them pelicans and all them, that's why you had to hide up the god inside the temple. Yeah. That's how I'm going to be outside. They're going to be far from where the shit on. They'll jump down from where
you jump. I
think for mommy was in verse 17.
Yeah, but
no. Verse 17. Yeah. No, 18, so like, yeah.
Yeah, 18.
I think they jumped.
It's about, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to verse 19 now.
Yeah, this is. Week 6 and verse 19.
He just jumping, so like, yeah, he just jumping back from where he left out. He just start back a little thing from on top and we jumping back on. We was continuing from verse 19. Go ahead.
It said they light them candles, yea, more than for themselves. Wherefore they cannot see one.
Go down.
Yeah, it said, verse 20, it said they are as one of the beam of the temple. Yet they say their hearts are grown upon things creeping out of the earth.
So like a beam in the temple. So they're different than a block in the temple. A same brick we can use a bill of a same temple. They come as the brick. They come just as equal as the brick. Mm-hmm. So but they worship the brick in the temple. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It say, and when they eat, them and their clothes, they feel it not.
Can they can't really feel that as we said before. They don't really be eating. They don't really be, you know, drinking nothing. We read that.
21. It say, their faces are black through the smoke that cometh out of the temple. Verse 22. It say, upon their bodies and heads. Sit back.
Go on.
Yeah, because sit up back just done on them. And shit on them.
Go ahead, give it to you. Go ahead.
See swallows and birds and the cats also.
You see? So we feel like that. But I start you, boy.
And you know what? They will say the God provided a home for me.
Hey, your question, I was going to say, funny boy, it's funny. These things funny to me. They know to me when I learn funny because, hey, they'll show you how we mind study these heathens. You understand? They could print out, they get them a piece of arrows here and they print it. You understand? But hey, your question, I was going to say, you know that we print the true power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You know who's sworn a covenant unto us, and we're going to see the kingdom of heaven. You understand? And all these other nations wouldn't be under our feet. You understand? Serving us as maid and handmaids. You understand? Being washed pot. You understand? Cooking and cleaning the house and building up our walls. Building up our house. You understand? Go ahead.
Yeah, verse 23. It says... But this he may know
by that... By this
you will know that they are no gods, therefore fear them not.
Yeah,
that is it.
Let's see, book as of now, chapter 2 and verse 10. that has a stem. This shall they have for their pride. Right? The same pride that I had before. When they could have saw the idols giving them this and that wealth and so forth.
Yeah,
because well, they have reproached. Call the Israelites, all them beggars, all this, all that. All they have nothing and all these things. And magnify themselves against the people of the Lord of hosts.
Mm.
The Lord will be terrible unto them. Because they die out in the streets.
Can.
You know, like dogs.
Can.
Being dumb upon the face can. Of the earth.
So let watch you and hiss and shake the head and hey, we know that we have a poor behind us. Who are they behind us? Or they have iron and they have cement behind us. You understand? But they build themselves with a cement and build a statue. You understand? Or you still have a corpse behind it inside the cement. That'll show you how these even of them glorify themselves when the Abashim Shai set it so for them to be high over us. You understand? And getting carried away. But hey, as the brother say, you understand? They getting destroyed and perishing.
For he will famish all the gods of the earth.
Can't so you without you see them right now. Mm-hmm. I know they need lake swimming and they can't even breathe. So they know they ain't drowning.
And men shall worship him, everyone from his place, even all the eyes of the heathens.
Can't.
Because they right now they're just gonna be going to and fro to all them idols and they'll realize no, there's no help.
Can't.
And the Lord gonna be so terrible with all these plagues and all these famines.
That's right.
They'll come to know Yahweh Hashem Yahushai.
Because in the year, in the year, I think last year, there's a woman, in the herself, so she's son and she daughter, and she self in them, where they bought water from?
A well.
You understand? A well, the dead in the well. Maybe. You understand? Because of famine. You understand? Because she had nothing to eat. So she killed herself and them children. You understand? So why did the idol goes in come and bring a pita food and feed them? You understand? That's why we high A and that's why all praise say about Shem and Shai. You see, he need anything, anyone call upon you about Shem and Shai and he will provide and we as brothers in the truth. We see this and we know this. You understand? Because we call upon Yahweh Shem Shai, he will fight for us. And as we as Kosher men, we just see Yahweh Shem Shai wonders. You understand? That is it there, sir?
Yeah,
that
is
it. You think, Yahweh?
You remember the Wisdom of Solomon 15 and 15?
Yeah.
It's the book of Wisdom of Solomon chapter 15 and verse 15. It says, for they counted all the idols of the heathen to be gods, which neither have use of eyes to see, nor noses to draw breath, nor ears to hear, nor fingers of hands to handle.
Can so look, I know they cast them in as I was saying earlier on, they cast them in the sea, they cast them in the rivers, they're swimming out of the river.
They can't
even fucking breathe. Go ahead.
They just had to think.
And as for their feet, they are slow to go and they can't move, right? So it's if for man made them and he that borrowed his own spirit fashioned them.
Oh.
But no man make a god like unto himself, right? No man can make a god like himself to make a god breathe and to make man walk.
Can.
You understand? Because that's what the Lord really showing you here, that can. a man can make spirit.
Can.
Right? For being mortal, he will get a dead thing with wicked hands.
Mm.
Right? For he himself is better than the thing which he worship.
Can.
Right?
Worship can.
Say whereas he lived once, but they never, right? So it come like you still have a life, but they never live.
Can.
But you worshiping this lifeless thing.
Can.
Right, and that's what it's called. It say, they worship those beasts also, that they are most hateful for being compared together. Some are worse than others. It say neither are they beautiful so much as to be desired in respect of beasts, but they went without the praise of Yahweh and his blessing. So you know, they even worshiping animals and cows and like that's how it goes, all that idol worship.
Can. So you know, hey, we close with the scripture here in Zephaniah chapter 2 verse 1, because this going to you know
even if the speckled birds is life for us and the whole nation of Israel. It's like gather yourself together, ye gather together, O nation, not desire before the decree, bring forth before the day pass, as a chaff before the fierce anger of your hour come upon you.
Can.
Before the weather.
Yeah, it's like gather yourself, O nation, not desire. You Spanish, them who coming down here and selling your body next to nothing.
Hmm.
Yeah, you Israelite men who working at the so-called Negroes. Hmm. Yeah, we doing all the mason work, all the hard work, the rubbish truck work. We doing all the laboring and these heathens just doing the reaping. The Lord say, now gather yourselves together before the decree bring forth that destruction. Come back unto your heritage and serve the Lord. They know you can do
it. Come with the sword, let me see the reapers. It say, before the day of Yahweh, anger come upon you.
Yeah, before the anger of the Lord, as meaning judgment. Because if you continue in your ways and keep, you know, doing the things that the heathens do, and then come back to your heritage, you will be in that lot to them.
Can.
You will be rendered with that same judgment and that same destruction as them.
The Bible says, come out of her, my people.
Can.
Come out of her, that's, you know, that's spiritually telling you to come out of her ways, come out of the things that they see them doing.
Can.
Worshipping idol, God, eating unclean, you know, and a whole heap of abomination.
Can.
Right?
So, you know that, we give all praises, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, and Kakodash. The blood of the apostles of great millstone go well, salvation to the Achaeans, who put your name truly and sincerity to the four corners of the earth as well. You know, to the world to our pastor listening and learning. You know, who this video was edifying through the spirit and power of Yahshua Mashiach. You know, as we've seen the healers them training with their idol gods, they all praise to Yahshua Mashiach and to the rest of the other nations, what about the world, and hey, that to Esau until the next one. Shalom.
Shalom.